I played one of the three times for Chelsea, but in 1986.
Come here, you black.
It was time to move on. So I transferred to Reading. Things were going really well. I was the exciting winger from Chelsea, their star player. And the goals were coming too. And then one match, crunch. When I looked down, I was shocked. There were lumps where there shouldn't be. They tried to fix it, but 10 months later, it was time to retire. I was only 24 and I was devastated. Now, music was the one thing I loved as much as football. I'd built up an impressive record selection over the years and made a bit of a name for myself as a DJ. So I could still make money doing that. It was a good buzz. I was pretty good at selecting the right tunes to fit the mood of the crowd. But one night, this geezer offers me a spliff. I take it off him and take a deep draw, then a few more. I get suspicious. It doesn't taste like marijuana. What is it, I say?
Crack!
I go absolutely mental. I take on crack without even knowing it. I was scared how it would affect me. I was sweating, frightened, then really confident and lively, but calm. And I was still able to DJ. Of course, now I look back and see that this was a bad outcome because I wanted more. At first, I get it free off my friends. Then I start to buy my own. It helped me forget my problems. I didn't tell anyone. I decided I'd only use it at the weekends, but before long, in the weekdays too. After a few years, I was on it every minute. I used to get terrible mood swings. Anything anybody would say, I'd blow up, even at my mum. I was so aggressive, and that's not me. When I was skint, I'd borrow off my girlfriends and never pay them back. In the end, I sold my precious record collection. And when the money from that ran out, I was on my way to rock bottom. It's 10 years later. I'm in the park. I used to dress sharp, but now I looked a mess. My friend Simon was jogging by, and he spotted me. He couldn't believe the state I was in. He really tried to help turn me around, but I needed professional help. It took a long time, but eventually he found me somewhere to get clean. 10 months later, I was feeling optimistic about the future. Suddenly, I felt a terrible pain. I went to see the doctor. It was cancer. I was seriously ill. I went through 2 years of treatment. Even lost my hair. It was a long slog, but eventually I started to recover. But just as I felt I'd got my life back, I was tempted by crack again. And pretty soon I was back on the street. Then eventually back in rehab again. And like before, just when I was getting back on my feet, the cancer returned. And I had to go through all the treatment all over again. The thing about drugs and illness is it takes up so much of your lifetime. In what felt like no time at all, it was 20 years since I've been a top player for Chelsea Football Club. That Paul was long gone. But one day, I get a message from them. Would I like to come to an event they're doing? I'm very surprised. I thought I'd been forgotten. Would anyone even remember me? Should I go? Should I not go? But eventually I went. And guess what? Everyone was happy to see me. I was amazed. It turned out I'd inspired all the black players who'd come through. I was like a hero to them, and I had no idea. I even met a guy called Pete who had been doing lessons about me in schools. Taking lessons about how bad racism used to be in football and how I was a role model with so many kids. He invited me to go to the classes with him and talk about my experiences. So I did. And I haven't looked back since, and this is my message. What I did, don't follow. Don't waste your life away on drugs. Drugs will ruin your life and damage your health. Talk to friends about how you're feeling if you've got problems. And even if you're talented at football like I was, work hard at school in all your lessons because you never know what could go wrong.
To save the children.